A debate has raged within the gaming community. The perceived value of native resolution versus the rapidly evolving capabilities of AI-enhanced rendering. The truth is, the era of native resolution is over. The traditional focus on native graphics has trapped the industry in a cycle of diminishing returns and unsustainable computational demands. This essay will expose the limitations of the native rendering scheme and demonstrate why AI-driven techniques, upscaling, and frame generation are not mere supplemental technologies, but rather the foundation of a superior and more sustainable approach to rendering. Criticizing AI generation as fake is akin to dismissing CGI in movies because it wasn't captured with a camera. What matters is the outcome, engaging, immersive visuals that enrich the experience. The traditional approach to achieving higher visual fidelity hinged on increasing the sheer number of pixels rendered natively. While this strategy yielded significant improvements in the past, it has reached its practical limits. The computational cost of native rendering scales exponentially with resolution, creating a scenario where even the top-tier GPUs struggle to maintain acceptable frame rates at 4K and beyond. This brute force approach has led to an era of diminishing returns, where escalating hardware demands deliver increasingly marginal visual improvements. Moreover, traditional anti-aliasing techniques, while attempting to smooth jagged edges, introduce their own artifacts with a pretty significant penalty to performance. These methods, alongside the pursuit of better resolutions, have proven increasingly unsustainable. This is where AI-driven upscaling comes in. Unlike traditional upscaling methods, AI-driven upscaling can not only solve this, but it achieves this with a significantly reduced performance cost compared to native rendering, making previous unplayable games playable. And while providing anti-aliasing, this performance saving is becoming increasingly significant as technology improves, requiring less and less resolution in order to make quality output. Also, if you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe. Tell me what you think in the comments. AI upscaling addresses the limitations of GPU scaling. Frame generation tackles a different yet equally critical bottleneck, the growing disparity between CPU and GPU performance. Modern games with their complex physics, AI, and simulations often still rely on heavy single-core CPU performance. This creates a scenario where even the most powerful GPUs can be held back by the CPU, leading to inconsistent frame times, stuttering, or an overall degraded gaming experience. Additionally, certain problems can happen within the game's engine itself, causing a lot of stuttering. Frame generation provides a powerful workaround to this problem. By analyzing motion vectors and employing deep learning algorithms, the technique effectively masks the performance dips caused by CPU limitations. By providing a steady stream of frames, even when the CPU is struggling to keep up, the technology can assure a more consistent and visual experience. This doesn't solve the CPU problem, and this is not about replacing the need for better CPU optimization, but providing a crucial buffer that can elevate the overall gaming experience. So what about the future of all this? Frame generation is a technology that's advancing rapidly beyond simple single frame interpolation. Current research demonstrates the future shows greater potential to generate multiple synthetic frames for each natively rendered frame, dramatically increasing fluidity and increasing temporal resolution while maintaining visual quality. This advancement promises to fundamentally alter how we think about frame rates. Rather than being constrained by hardware limitations, frame delivery will be determined by display capabilities, with frame generation filling any gaps to match the monitor's refresh rate precisely. The integration of frame generation with asynchronous time warping represents another critical advancement. Asynchronous time warping, initially developed for virtual reality applications, enables the modification of rendered frames based on latest input data. This technology reorients the frame to reflect updated input parameters, such as head or controller movements. The principles of asynchronous time warping extend naturally to frame generation, addressing one of its primary limitations, input responsiveness. Current frame generation implementations face a fundamental constraint. Interpolated frames cannot react to new inputs until the next natively rendered frame. The integration of asynchronous reprojection offers a solution. By modifying the non-interactable AI-generated frames according to the most recent user input data by making non-interactable frames interactable can significantly reduce input latency. The result is a more responsive gaming experience that maintains the benefits of frame generation while mitigating its primary drawback. This approach, adapting dynamically to both system capabilities and user input, could render traditional fixed frame concepts obsolete. Overall, in the end, AI technologies democratize high-quality gaming experiences. They allow mid-tier systems to achieve results that were once reserved for high-end rigs, enabling broader access to better graphics and smoother gameplay. For developers, AI reduces the burden of pushing raw hardware limits, creating room for more creative freedom. This attachment to native rendering as the only legitimate form of visual presentation keeps developers tethered to hardware-intensive, resource-draining approach that stifles innovation, which benefits few players and ultimately limits the medium.